Good morning and welcome to the day four devotion of the 21-day prayer and devotion with me. And thank you for joining us today. Hope what you have been learning so far has been helpful to you. We talked about a new season God is inviting us into to experience a new thing that He's doing within our lives. But in order for us to experience a new thing, we must have a new heart, a heart that flees away from wrong desires but pursues righteousness, faith, love, and peace. That's what we looked at so far. But today we also are going to talk about another area where we need to change in order for us to experience the new season. Jesus, talking to his disciples in Mark chapter 2, makes a very interesting statement about wineskins. Let's look at that in chapter 2, verses 22. "And no one pours new wine into old wineskins. Otherwise, the wine will burst the skins, and both the wine and the wineskins will be ruined. No, they pour new wine into new wineskins." How many of you enjoy new things in your life? Chances are, if you enjoy change, the word new is always almost exciting to us, mostly exciting to us. Every time we hear something called new. But for those of us who don't really like change, then the word new is usually stressful for us. But if we are honest to ourselves, every time we allowed a change to take place so that a new thing can happen, we have realized that we have always grown from where we are to a better place, became better person, better people. New experiences usually lead us to a season of growth. They take us through the seasons of change, and that change brings growth within us. Personally, corporately, as a family, in many ways, we see a change within us, growth within us. When I became a father the first time, I had no idea how to be a father. I was stressed. Half of the time, I wasn't sure how to take care of my children. All the old thinking, all the old strategies that I had, or the experience that I had in the past, never really actually helped me to this new thing that is in my hand. I mean, while this is bringing joy to me, it is also bringing stress to me. But at the same time, this parenthood had actually helped me to become better as a person. It in fact brought a rapid change and brought a growth within me, and it helped me to dismiss what my old lifestyle was and change my lifestyle, adjust my behavior patterns, adjust the way I think and do things in order to enjoy the new thing that is placed in my life. I had to immediately replace old with new, with helpful things, new helpful things. So that's the analogy that Jesus is trying to give to his disciples in Mark chapter 2, when he's talking about old wineskins with new wine. You see, when a new wine is being fermented, it releases gases. Now these, when this wine is being fermented and it's releasing gases, only a new wineskin can actually hold firm, can withstand the expansion caused by the gases released through wine. Now, putting a new wine into old wineskin, which is no longer pliable, is asking for trouble. That's what Jesus was trying to say. The expansion of the fermenting of gases will stress it beyond its breaking point, causing the old wineskin to burst. Both wine and the skin then are lost. You know, it's ruined. The whole process is ruined. In the same way, we cannot have a fresh experience of God with old mindset. Just like how the 10 spies out of the 12 who went to explore the promised land came back with a bad report about the promised land. God had new territories, new conquests in mind for Israel, for all these Hebrews who are now, you know, coming from Egypt to enter into the promised land. But then the 10 spies saw themselves as grasshoppers and continued on with this slavish mentality. And that confined them from exploring new things, from conquering new things in their lives. Their actions, in fact, brought a great setback, not only in, you know, for them, but the entire generation that could have actually enjoyed new things in their lives. You see, sometimes we allow our old mindset, old way of thinking, old way of looking at life and people, keep us from moving forward and explore new things that God is asking us to explore and enjoy and experience. Today, this is why the Bible tells us that our minds need to be constantly renewed by meditating on God's word. In the book of Romans, chapter 12, Paul was exactly making the same point to us, asking us to renew our mind, constantly being transformed into a different person. I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. That's a change of heart. This is your true and proper worship. But then, not just the heart transformation, we talked about heart transformation yesterday, not just the heart transformation, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve God's will, what God's will is, His good, pleasing and perfect will. So here is the point. It's not just a change of heart, it's necessary for us to have a change of mind. If we don't change the way we think, we will find it difficult to have the courage to explore new things, to attempt new things. But it is unless you explore and attempt new things in your life, how can you experience the new season? You can't. That's why the challenge for you today is to ask yourself, what are the areas and circumstances in your life that you feel never change? Take some time to allow God to change your mindset and perspective on those areas. You know, sometimes we tend to give up on new things because we think what we have right now doesn't change. And that mindset keeps us from moving forward. So what are those areas of your life and that you need to allow God to bring about a change? Mindsets. What are some new things that you can attempt for God? Think about that too. While you do reflect on what are things that are stopping you from exploring, you also need to think about what are the new things that God is asking you to, new areas of exploration that you need to make in, new ways that you can find to serve Him in this season. That way, this new season can actually become fruitful for you. So think about that today and ask God, God, renew my mind through your spirit, through your word. Give me your perspective to look at my circumstances in a fresh way. Give me a new attitude to serve you with courage. And I'm ready to learn, God. If you pray that prayer, God will help you to learn, change and grow. You're ready to allow the new wine to be poured into your new wineskin, the mindset. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.